Hello everybody and welcome to Jay's To-Do List. Today I'm going to show you how to do laser engraving and how to convert a photo to a laser engravable file. And at the very end I'll talk to you a little bit about my suppliers with some lumbers and which lumbers I would suggest using for this process. Stick tuned, it's going to be really fun.
Hey guys, welcome back to Jay's To-Do List. Today I want to show you how to do the how to do laser engraving into wood and how to lay it out through CorelDRAW. This is fairly a difficult process. I'm going to go ahead and show you what I do, at least how I do it, and show you some final results. So let's go ahead and import a, let's go ahead and import in a image here. Sorry, we're working on some signs for my company here. And I just have a stock photo right here. And first thing I'm going to do, as you can see, we imported this image here, and it's 11 by 16-ish, so it's a good quality video photo. You'll want to make sure you're working with a good quality photo. A customer, say, sent you over a thumbnail, the last thing you want to do is actually make the photo bigger, because what you'd be doing is you're just stretching out the pixels. So make sure you're working with a good quality sized photo for what you're doing. Make sure you are not making it larger like this, because all you're going to be doing is spreading out those pixels and you create a worse image. So I have this nice big photo here, and this image I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna turn it into a ornament, say a Christmas ornament. We typically put ours about 3 inches by 3 inches into a round here, and I'll go ahead and show you guys here a little hole at the top of the Christmas ornament. There we go. I'm gonna go ahead and group that together just so it's grouped. All right, so we have our image. We want to go ahead and, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this all out here, because who wants all this noise on their Christmas ornament? Let's go. Make sure you got the picture. Make sure you got the picture selected. Click your crop tool. And there we go. Crop that out. I don't like that. Sorry guys, this is really a process. And then I'm going to resample my bitmap. You see we're still a little large. We only need 3 inches here. So we'll go to bitmap and click resample. And what this does, this is makes the software in here take these pixels and make them the proper. I could actually make this larger or smaller. Preferably don't go larger if you can get away with it. When you're laser engraving, 300 dots per inch is ideal. And we're about 3 inches, so let's go ahead and make this 3 inches tall. See how that looks inside of our circle. Let's size this a little bit so it fits a little better. And again, I'm just trying to show you guys the image resizing here. I'm getting it ready. Let's see, his head's cut off. I don't really like that. Okay. That's not too bad. So let's work with this image here. All right, so I actually shrunk it a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and convert back to bitmap. I want 300 dots per inch. RGB scale is what I typically work in. So boom, we're now 300 dots per inch. The first, now getting this particular image ready for laser engraving is the tricky part. So there's a few little tricks I know here to make this work a little better. So go ahead and go into your bitmaps. And the first thing I like to do is go to sharpen, which is, I'm sorry, it's under effects up at the top. Go to sharpen and unsharpen mask. And you'll kind of see it starts making the unsharpening the image. Basically, it's pulling the darkness and the brightness away. So we can move this. We can make it however we want. But I've discovered a little more unsharp, the better. On a, we don't want to go crazy because then it starts to look strange. So I'll put it right here. For this particular image, it's going to change on every single one. So stop when you think it looks good. And it's going to be pretty hard to decide where that is. But this time it's 192 on the percentage. the radius is all the way up to 20, and my threshold is all the way down. So you can play with the radius, which just makes means it's not going to sharpen as much at a time, but we'll go ahead and keep it pretty daggone unsharpened. And your threshold, again, only thing you really mess with, I have my radius turned all the way up, and then I move the percentage up. This one's up to 192 before I got to something I thought looked good. Okay, now you can go to bitmap and adjust contrast enhancement. And this one is, this slide here represents our black. You see I already have it up, it's normally on zero. I already had it up just a smidget, it was about 35 or so. You can actually just type 35 in right there. Jimmy Christmas, guys. Adjust contrast enhancement, and then sorry, I shouldn't hit enter. It will bring away the white about this here, and what this is doing is eliminating complete 100% black pixels and complete 100% white pixels. So there should be no definite black area in here, and there should be no definite white area in here. So those are the two tools that I use to get them ready for this next process. We'll go ahead and do the next process, set it up, and we'll see what it looks like. And sometimes we have to go back in there and adjust a few more things before we get something that looks just right. Now, okay. Next step is make sure you have your photo selected. Bitmaps, and we use mode. You click black and white. Don't run grayscale because your machine reads when it's engraving black and white. It doesn't read gray, so it'll only engrave the black and the black, and it won't engrave the white, and it won't engrave the grayscale. So we don't want black and white. We want to go to mode. I'm sorry, we only want black and white. So mode, black and white. And there's a few modes here on this conversation. You'll see if line art, order, Jarvis, Stucky, and all these other ones. The one I like to use is Jarvis. And then typically I move the intensity, and you can see as you move this switch, more and less dots. So I typically think they look good around the 50% mark, sometimes a little better, sometimes a little less. Get it to where you think that this looks pretty good here. So I'm actually going to go right for 50%, and then I'll click OK. Now remember, this particular photo, their faces was actually blurry, and then really they're focused on the I said yes here on the hand. So we're about 50% mode, and next, now you want to go up here to your view. I have mine right here, and I'm going to click 100%. So that would give you a good idea of what the photo should look like when we're done engraving. Really, the major artwork on this image is going to be in the laser side, and I'm going to jump over to that just so you guys can see how I set this up on the laser and get it ready to cut out and engrave this Christmas ornament. I assume I guess it could be a wedding favor. But how I engrave this on the wood. And take this, and you can actually right-click on this, power-clip this into the circle, and then we'll go ahead and select, and just get this to where, just move this around here, get her elbow away from the edge. And that should work. His head's not going to get cut off here. It's all good and hunky-dory and happy right there, and this is probably good to send to the laser. We'll see what this looks like. Export, and let's go ahead and let's see. I'm going to do this with my blue laser, and I like to save mine as AI files, so this is just a YouTube ornament engrave. And we'll get that pulled up. I'll probably engrave this tomorrow for you guys to check out. Hopefully this helps your process. So I'll show you my finished product. And again, the major work in this is really figuring out your settings and laser, which I'll show you here in just a second. Stay tuned.
It's cold outside. I'm glad I'm in my crappy barn where it's heated. Speaking of that, we actually have a new facility we're working on. You should check out my company's Facebook page, Footsteps in the Past. I'll put a link in the description. You can check out the new building that we're building to be running all these laser machines and building our signs. Okay, so now we have the image ready to go. So we're going to turn on the machine and set it to the perimeters on the machine here and get this thing engraving. But first, before I do that, I need to talk to you a little bit about wood and what you're trying to engrave this on. What I'm going to use, I got a piece of scrap here. This is a 1/4-inch birch plywood. I'll put a link down below where I get this particular plywood. Is I get from Home Depot. It's my favorite 1/4-inch birch plywood they have. I'll put a link down below. I'm getting 4-foot by 8-foot sheets and really save yourself some money by cutting to the size of what your machines are. So this one's a piece of scrap, and I'm only running 6 or 7 ornaments tonight for you guys. Again, here's specifically for you. So let's get this thing in there and let's see how it goes. Okay, so I'm running this plywood on my machine. Every plywood, every machine, you have a little bit of a different perimeter. So you need to find that sweet spot in yours, but this is a great place to start. This is running at 275 millimeters a second, 25% power. And I've said it many, many times, try not to run your machines below 20% power or above 85% power. It's just unnecessary wear on the tubes. Okay, well, the laser's running here. We'll talk just a little bit about plywoods and about lumbers and what you're going to use in the engravings for photo engravings specifically. I am running a plywood. It has a thicker than normal veneer on it, so I'm attempting to not burn all the way through the veneer into the center wood, which on this plywood happens to be poplar, so it'd be changing species and therefore it wouldn't look very good if you went through all the veneer all the way. You could use a Baltic birch, however, I have not found a good Baltic birch that I like that cuts well in my machine. If you guys know a supplier of a Baltic birch that cuts 1/4-inch, you can cut 1/4-inch birch very efficiently, let me know in the comments below. But as of right now, I've tried multiple wholesalers in different hardware stores, Lowe's, Home Depot, Menards, that type of stuff. I have not found one, a Baltic birch that I am happy with for laser cutting. If you're doing photo etching, I would suggest using a solid wood. A maple, hard maple, is a very, very, very good. Cherry and walnut are very good for laser engraving photos. They say the best is alder. I don't like alder because it has a lot of knots in it, so you get a lot of waste. So I prefer maple. Here in Ohio, maple is easy to get a hold of. Then cherry and walnut. I've worked with all of those on laser engraving for photos. I do a lot of ornaments on photo engraving, but we just wind up using our birch plywood. Again, I have that birch in the description below. So now we get the weight here. I'm actually doing 6 or 7 or 8, I don't remember. Oh, we're only doing 6. I got 6 orders today for photo engraving, so those are engraving right now, and I'll get back to you when they're done. Just be a few minutes. Really, any of the woods that bear fruit have a lot of sugar in them, or a birch, which has a good sugary sap in it, does really well with laser engraving. I believe that's what the link is the amount of sugar content in the wood. I could be crazy. Again, let me know below if I'm crazy, but I think that's what is for me from my experience and found. Anything that has a lot of sugar content, walnut, you say it doesn't bear fruit, but yeah, it does. It bears nuts. And you can actually make walnut syrup. If you didn't know about that, I really love making my own maple syrup, and I have a lot of videos on how to do that. I know it doesn't really fit in with laser engraving, but hey, I like to do it, and I'm sorry, but not sorry. Oh my goodness, guys, I completely forgot something extremely important. This is an 80-watt machine. I'm running 20 millimeter mirrors, and it goes down to an 18 millimeter laser lens, which is really small, but it's all right. And I'm running at a 2-inch. This is what most of you are going to be running, is 2-inch. Most machines come with 2-inch. The shorter distance, the more sharp your laser beam is going to be coming out. So if you have 1.5 inches, laser lens or a 1-inch laser lens, your photos are going to be good. If you have 2.5 or 3-inch, you're going to get your loose quality as they go out. So a 2-inch is the longest focal lens that I would recommend for doing laser engraving. If you have 1.5 inches, use 1.5 inches. I have 1.5 inches. Don't know why I didn't use it. Probably just because I didn't want to switch it out, because a 2-inch will look just fine. Right, they're done. I haven't seen them yet. Sweet, these look awesome. Get a little dust off of it. There's one we were working on. I don't know if you guys can make that out. First try. There's a few other ones we worked on. It's a group of people. Little cowboy dude. Two puppy dogs sitting next to each other. That one's not very good, but it's all right. Would be better on solid wood, but these look pretty good. So there's actually some depth in that. I don't know if you guys can see that. You get it way up here. You see, even says to them, oh, look at that. I almost forgot I had to mirror tell you that some machines, it says I said yes on her hand. Some machines you got to mirror them, but you just need to know your machine. Mine's set up, I don't have to. So I just thought I would mention that, but that's what we're working on. Woohoo, it's in Boston wood. Lasts as long as it lasts. And I'm working on my thumbnail like I always do, guys. And I'm going to show you real quick that I have a photo that I've printed onto wood, because I couldn't find a photo out here in the wood shop because I don't put anything on paper. So I was going to hold up this disc of wood like this. And for my thumbnail, so I'm going to hold up this disc of wood like this in this photo here. And I'm like, how in the world do you get this photo laser engraved into this? I don't know. And then that's probably going to be my thumbnail. So I'll put this at the end. So we'll see how that goes. Thanks for watching.